Hello everyone and welcome to today's episode of Beyond the Mask. In today's episode I want to give you guys a new concept idea for a Resident Evil movie pack that I have envisioned for Dead by Daylight. The movies for Resident Evil are actually pretty much well known and they're not always very well received by Resident Evil fans. They did sort of stray away from the game storyline, which is one of the reasons why people weren't really fond of them. However, I've always actually enjoyed them and I've always especially liked the first one. So I wanted to sort of give a concept idea for the movies and how to introduce Alice as a survivor and also bring in a killer and a new map as well. So without further ado, let's get into this video. The pack will include a new killer, which will be the Licker, a new survivor, which would be Alice, and a new map, the Hive, which is an underground facility in the first Resident Evil movie. So first let's go straight to the killer. The Licker has appeared in the Resident Evil games and I want to sort of borrow the origins of the Licker from the games but just sort of blend it in with the movies like they did in the first one. As with most killers, the Licker will have its own ability and the ability will be called Biohazard. With T-Virus enhancing abilities through the Licker's body, it is able to create a violent frenzy. Special ability, G-Virus Frenzy. The power button grants you the ability to perform a rush action. Doing so consumes a token. As G-Virus Frenzy is activated, the Licker can infect survivors with a G-Virus strain. Doing so will put the survivor in the injured state and applying the deep wound status effect. Once a survivor has been infected with the G-Virus, the Licker can see a thermal aura of all survivors. Once the frenzy has ended, the Licker will enter a short recovery time. Special attack, a Licker's Tongue. After G-Virus Frenzy has caused a survivor to enter the injured state, hit the power button. The Licker's Tongue will activate and can attack any survivor within a 10 meter radius. Add-ons, perk number 1, Mutation. After hooking each survivor for the first time, your abilities increase to 20, 30, 40%. Movement recovery increase and cooldown experiences a decrease. This lasts for 30 seconds and can only be reactivated after each survivor has been hooked for the first time. Second perk, Hextinction. After a survivor destroys this Hex Totem, the survivor's aura is revealed to all survivors and decreases their movement and action speed by 5, 6, 7%. The Hex will continue until the player who destroyed the totem is placed into the struggle stage on a hook. Hex, Blood Pact. The drop of a survivor's blood brings forth the entity. Every time a survivor is placed into the injured state, the entity blocks all windows within 16 meters of your location. The entity holds them in place for 15 seconds, the windows cannot be vaulted through. Blood Pact has a cooldown of 48 seconds. So that's all of what would come with the Licker. Now the Licker's sort of G-Virus infection with the ability would be very similar to how Nemesis does, and I think it would be nice for them to have the whole searching for a cure the same way they do for Nemesis. Moving on to Survivor, we've got Alice, who will come with three different skins. One of them is her red dress from the original Resident Evil movie. A second skin will be the black coat she has over that outfit. And then a third, very rare skin, will be the outfit that she wore in Resident Evil Apocalypse. Her perks would be this. There's something down there. You can sense danger almost instantly. As you enter a trial, the killer's aura is revealed to you for 15 seconds. Not on the menu. Once you've reached the struggle phase after being hooked, if the killer stays within a 40 meter range of the hook, the struggle timer will not decrease. We struggle, we fight, we watch our friends die, survival is a bitch. Gotcha. While in a chase with the killer, press the active ability button whilst running through a stationary pallet. This will trigger a trap that automatically stuns the killer once they've run through it. You leave no scratch marks for 3 seconds. Moving on to location, we would be getting the Hive from Resident Evil 2002, with its very close, sort of claustrophobic environment that the Hive had. It would be very similar to Hawkins. The only difference is that it would be scattered more with Resident Evil-esque areas. So I think that the narrow corridors would be great. And then also I think we should have Dining Hall B, and then the laser corridor. And I think that that, with the knowledge that there's, say, going to be a Licker in there, for example, that can just lunge down corridors at you, would make the environment extremely terrifying. So that's my overall concept for a Resident Evil movie pack for Dead by Daylight. If you sort of want to see this pack made, then be sure to share this around, get this out there, because Dead by Daylight are pretty well known for listening to fans when it comes to requesting licensed themes, and I know that Resident Evil's a big property and they are actively making stuff for it at the moment. So I think if you sort of want this pack and you think it's a great idea, then please be sure to keep sharing it to get your voices heard. Thank you very much for watching this video, guys. Don't forget to like the video. It lets me know that you're enjoying this content. Closing off this video, I'm going to leave it on a quote from Resident Evil 2002.
I don't know what we had, but it's over.
Like scary.